Hello and welcome. Today is Friday, the 22nd of September 2017. And I'm taking a look at the Starcoin. I'm gonna go over this particular one, not only because, well, not because I like this coin. In fact, I really know nothing about it. I really don't like or dislike this any more than any of the other ones. I just like the strategy of trading, and I just need codes that move to trade with, and this one moves. Okay. So what the strategy is when you see stuff going up like this is you don't want to be a buyer when it's going straight up. You don't want to be a buyer up here. It's, to me, nonsense and just not a good strategy to do such. You want to wait for it to settle down or crash back down if it's going to keep pumping and dumping. And these pumping and dumping is perfect for this strategy, hence why I like to do this. I also want to do this when I think there's going to be some volatility movements. And after this big green candle move going to 3,400, now back to 1,261, after it rose from below the 800 level, well, this is looking good to me. Let me just quickly look at the Fibonacci. And I don't know what the numbers are as I'm saying this, but we got 3,400 high. We got a low here under 700. Let me bring up my script. This is something I've made myself using a small basic programming language, and it just does the exponential math. It doesn't matter which number I put in first. Let's just do 3,411. That looks fair enough. And let's do the slot machine. 1367, 1938. So it's at that key 618. And it usually pierce extra. So 1367, you expect it to go a bit below. This is basically the buying spot as it is anyway. So it does make for a very good entry position. My strategy is you calculate how much you want to play, and then you decide where you want to buy the remainder. If you want to buy the remainder, meaning, do you just buy it all now? And just if it goes down, what are you going to do? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be buying some now. I haven't bought yet. I'll be pausing the tape, although it's not a tape, making a purchase, and then making a buy order. Now, usually a thousand's a psychological number. You also want to take a look, if you can, at the bid-ask ratio. And on the purchase, you want to decide, okay, where do I want to sell? Generally speaking, I'm going to probably want to put a seller here. When I look at this number, that's about 1600. It was an area of resistance in here. Also, when I look at the numbers in mathematics, that's a gain of 340 points or so in the 1200 variable. So we're looking at about a little under 30% of a gain. So it's not bad for an opening sell position. And then you probably want to put maybe a sell order here. Definitely one up in here again, like maybe around 3,000, and then again at around these numbers here. So it means you, I'll probably put a 0.02 spot now, and then look to buy another 0.01 to 1.015 on the lower levels. So that's what will be done. This is the hourly chart, and I have already made my purchases, my purchase, my sell orders, and one other buy order. And I'm going to just talk about this again when it either falls to 1,000 or it climbs to 1525. I don't need to even look at it, as long as it's in that range, because nothing's going to happen. So 1,579 and change, but at 1,263 Satoshi. And in case it goes lower, 1,003. And that's a strategic buy order based on the orders in the book, as well as its psychological number. And we'll take a look at that 1,000 number momentarily. And I've put three sellers in. 292 and change at 15 and a quarter, 391 and change at a little over 21 and three quarters, and 1 basis point lower than 3,000, selling a little over 496, leaving 400 back. So this is a strategy that I do. And I'm really going over this to just give an example. It really doesn't matter the code. And I really am giving you a code of, you know what, this is whatever. If I was to rank my top 40 cryptos, this isn't going to make it because, I mean, I just started getting into Start. And I'm, yeah, that's really all there is to say about it. But the strategy for any type of big code is if you have this kind of move and they just fall down like this, then you wait for it to have its significant move and you wait for it to sell. And then when it sells, well, let's just assume the next order is going to be sell 292 at 15 and a quarter. Then that means the price action is going to be getting up to about here. So I'm going to be looking to put a buy order back in at around maybe 1280 to 1300. And I'll pretty much buy back, well, if I sell about 300. And then if it goes to straight up to 391, or if I sell the 391, that is for 50 to 2179, and then I'd be looking to buy back maybe about 350 at a much lower price, probably closer to 1300. And if I buy at 1003, that means I'll be looking to sell in the 1200s. Because if a situation of a fall happens to exist and price action makes it to this point, which is also matching these levels of resistance as well, then you know you're probably going to at least bounce to where you come from. And that's where it is now. So in that situation, I know if it goes down here, buying here and selling here on any random code that I just happen to see with this formation, for me, is viable for myself to put a wager on, and I really emphasize the word a wager, while tolerating, understanding your risk and your reward. Only placing something small so that if it loses, so be it, because I expect that when I make like 100 of these kinds of wagers, well, more. Most of them are going to work out, but some of them won't. There might be like 81 that will be doing fine. And of the 19, maybe 2 to 3 barely lose, and 3 to 4 get their asses kicked like no other, or 5 or 6 of them will. So be it. That's going to happen. In fact, I had a situation just recently where I bought something on one exchange that did something like this. I bought it like maybe up in here, but you don't buy here. Yeah, I know. I bought it, say, here when it was trading at another exchange in here. Okay, so I'll just buy it and transfer it. Oh, it took about 18 hours to transfer. That sucks. And when it came in, the price action was down 70%. You know what? That happens. And you take the losses. Risk, reward. And understand the two and implement that within the strategy. That's what I like to do. So anyway, this is it for the video. I will talk about this coin. Not again. Until it either reaches 1,000 or 15 and a quarter. Actually, 1,003. I mean, technically, it doesn't have to go to 1,000. It can go to 1,001. It can go to 1,003 because that's where I'm lying on. Take care. And, of course, anything you do is your own risk and your own reward.